orbit beyond the blue.
Our universe, and I mean the known universe, is bursting with stars and planets that revolve around their host stars. Despite all our technological advancements, we've barely explored 5% of the universe. The rest of the 95% remains a mystery. With the statistics of our exploration being so minuscule, there is absolutely no way that we can say for certain that we are alone. And there are many who genuinely believe that we are not alone. Some of the greatest physicists of the 20th and 21st century, like Carl Sagan and Stephen Hawking, remained hopeful for contact with other civilizations. Harvard astrophysicist Avi Loeb is willing to support and offer his services in the hunt for alien civilizations. With renowned physicists backing the study and hunt for other civilizations, we're no longer a society that scoffs at UFO and UAP sightings. Recently, a team of astronomers discovered something unusual while mapping out the universe. A mysterious object sending bursts of energy every 20 minutes. The object is around 4,000 light years away, and although that may seem far, its energy bursts were so big that it was one of the largest radio sources in the sky. The burst would happen for 1 minute, every 20 minutes, before it would disappear for a few hours, and then repeat the cycle. This object was appearing and disappearing over a few hours during our observations, an astrophysicist and lead author of the study said in a statement that was completely unexpected. It was kind of spooky for an astronomer because there's nothing known in the sky that does that. Is it alien intelligence trying to reach out to us? Are we finally set to make the quote-unquote zero first contact? Or is it a phenomenon that has a natural explanation? But what makes this object unusual is that it doesn't behave like a transient. A slow transient would have energy bursts that occur over the course of a few days before disappearing for months at a time. Fast transients flash on and off within milliseconds or seconds, so seeing one flash for up to a minute would be unprecedented. The team does have guesses as to what it can be, but they still aren't exactly sure. One idea Hurley Walker has is it could be an ultra-long period magneto. Magnetars are known to emit fast radio bursts, or FRBs. Fast radio bursts are flashes of as yet unknown physical origin. The majority of FRBs have been seen only once. The one that was detected recently, however, had multiple bursts. Researchers believe that FRBs originate from magnetically powered neutron stars. But the recent discovery of the repeating FRBs seems to suggest a completely different point of origin. Not from a young star, but rather from an old stellar cluster, located in the direction of the nearby galaxy M81. An old stellar cluster is a galaxy filled with old stars. Scientists find this location to be a highly strange one for the fast radio bursts, as FRBs are typically located in the zones of young stars. The high-resolution view of the extremely energetic flash could provide more insights as to where and why these FRBs arise. It took 12 radio telescopes working together to accomplish the research, showing how complex the nature of the search is and how much precision is required to catch one of these fleeting objects swiftly. Not only is this scenario an unlikely one, but also increasingly bizarre for the researchers involved who have never encountered this situation before. Astronomers pinpointed the flash within a set of old stars, called a globular cluster, in the galaxy M81. The galaxy is well known to amateur astronomers because it is extremely bright and relatively close, being only 12 million light years away from Earth. But the burst's location was a surprise finding, as all previous FRBs were found in zones with young stars. Such is the shock and disbelief among the scientific community that the astronomers were determined to dig further for the source, as they vehemently believed that it had to be something else besides the old stars present in M81. Previous studies have suggested that we have been looking for alien life in all the wrong places. Some astronomers believe that we should be looking for intelligent life in ancient star clusters, ones that existed long before the formation of Earth. But then, recently, a radio signal was detected, which had originated from the region of Proxima Centauri, 4.37 light-years away from us. While it may seem far, the next Sun-like star is just 3 times away from us. The third brightest star in our sky, it comes from a triple star system consisting of the binary star pair Alpha Centauri A and B, and Alpha Centauri C or Proxima Centauri. Alpha Centauri A and B, the two stellar companions, are relatively close to each other. Both stars are quite similar to the Sun. Alpha Centauri A shines with yellow light and is 1.5 times brighter than the Sun, while Alpha Centauri B is half as bright with an orange hue. Alpha Centauri A is a little bigger than our Sun, and Alpha Centauri B is smaller, so our Sun fits exactly right between them. The pair is also older than the Sun, with an age of 5 billion years. But where among the stars did the signal come from, and from what? Discovered by the Breakthrough Listen project, the signal has been dubbed as Breakthrough Listen Candidate 1, or BLC1. The project was established to seek extraterrestrial communication in the universe by intelligent organisms. Garnering roughly $100 million in financing, the project has dedicated thousands of hours of telescope observation time from around the world while using cutting-edge facilities. The signal was detected by the CSIRO POX radio telescope in New South Wales, Australia. The telescope, as usual, was observing the region of the nearest star to our Sun, Proxima Centauri, and it almost went undetected among the large volumes of data collected over the time of thousands of hours, but the scientists discovered it like a needle in the hay. For the signal to be considered, it needs to have two definite traits. First, it has to be limited to a small band of frequencies, just like radio, as such signals are unusual, as no natural mechanism in space can create such a signal. The second property, it should consist of a frequency that fluctuates according to the analogous motion of the exoplanet relative to Earth. The scientists had to go through nearly 4 million individual signals picked up by the telescope in Australia. And after much sifting and discarding of unnecessary signals, they were able to find 5,000 distinct ones. And among them was the chosen one. A single signal, which could not be explained after cross-checking with contemporary radio transmitters on Earth. It was a one-of-a-kind techno signature with narrow broad and that came only when the telescope was pointing towards Proxima Centauri and appeared over 30-hour observation period. And on deep diving, the derived location turned out to be Proxima B, discovered by astronomers in 2016 by using the radial velocity method, where a star doesn't remain completely stationary when it's being orbited by planets. Due to the gravitational tug of the small planets, the star will move in a small little circle. Extremely sensitive spectrographs are used by researchers to track a star's light spectrum. The star's light appears a little blue shifted when there is a planet around it, and a little red shifted when it moves away from the planet. When these shifts are repeated after a fixed number of days, months, and years at regular intervals, then it is accepted that the shifting of light is definitely caused by the to and fro tugging done by a planetary body orbiting around a star. Upon closer inspection, Proxima B turns out to be identical to Earth. The exoplanet seems to have a radius of 1.1 Earths and a mass of 1.3 times our planet with an equivalent density. It's a rocky world. There are differences too. First is the location of the two planets in their solar system. Proxima B is much closer to its parent star, located only 0.05 astronomical units away from it. Even Mercury is at a distance of 0.04 astronomical units, making Proxima B closer to its star. With such distance, the planet should be a fiery hell just like Mercury, correct? But Proxima Centauri is a faint-red dwarf, and just like Earth, it receives 60% energy from its star, making the planet orbit in the habitable zone, and this means life could potentially exist there. There are countless numbers of unknown planets scattered across our universe. We have already discovered an astonishing 4,935 exoplanets, and recently, we came across 65 new planets that has taken our tally to 5,000. The latest batch of 65 exoplanets were added to the NASA Exoplanet Archive on March 21st this year, marking the start of the planetary odometer. The JWST is the most advanced telescope ever made, and it is 100 times more powerful than its predecessor. With its help, we can unravel the secrets of this boundless expanse. In the past, we have discovered all kinds of planets: small, rocky worlds, gas giants larger than Jupiter, and extremely hot inhabitable planets. Out of all of these, there are a few planets that stand out. Kepler 1649 Centauri is one such planet. Its characteristics are very similar to Earth. In fact, this is the most habitable planet that we have discovered that may shelter life. Till now, we have been able to find 55 of these Earth-like planets, but not yet been able to study all. With the rate at which our technology is advancing, and mostly because of the James Webb, who knows what we might be capable of in the future? Wouldn't it be amazing to come across a planet that can sustain life? One of Webb's primary goals during its first year of science missions is to find and study extraterrestrial worlds beyond our solar systems, with a focus on how they form, as well as the possibility of them having water and biological life. Webb's research into star and planet formation allows us to link studies of mature exoplanets to their birth conditions, as well as our own solar system to its origins. Webb's infrared capabilities are perfect for revealing how stars and planets are formed for three particular reasons. Infrared light penetrates dust well, takes up the thermal signatures of young stars and planets, and indicates the presence of key chemical constituents, like water and organic chemistry. Mid-infrared light may pass through clouds that are 20 times thicker than visible light. This is especially important when looking at newborn stars that are concealed inside their natal clouds. As these clouds haven't dispersed for these young stars yet, we can't see visible light. Webb's infrared capabilities are crucial because they allow us to see, investigate, and grasp the early stages of star formation, when gas and dust are still squeezing inwards to give birth to young stars. But there's more to natal star clouds than that. Young stars and giant planets both start off as huge, puffy structures that gradually contract over time. While newborn stars become hotter as they grow older, the giant planets become colder, but they both emit more light in the infrared than visible wavelengths. That means Webb will excel at finding new stars and planets, and can aid in our understanding of the physics of their formation. MIRI will also look for heated molecular gas near numerous young stars, which could indicate the formation of rocky, potentially habitable planets. Astronomers will be able to reach an agreement on the concentration of bulk molecules, including the beginnings of ice, at the earliest phases of planet formation, thanks to such observations. It's no wonder that a large portion of Webb's early scientific work focuses on determining how planetary systems construct molecules that may be crucial for the advent of life as we know it.
Orbit. Beyond the blue.